Okay, so we want to start chapter 2 today. This is about the derivative. And we'll get into the meat of calculus here in this chapter. So the first thing I want to remind you of is that we started talking about, and I made reference to the derivative back when we were looking at instantaneous rates of change. Instantaneous. There we go, rates of change. Which we defined at some point to be the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Now it turns out this is really the definition. This is at some point x. And if you remember when we did instantaneous rates of change, we said, okay, find the instantaneous rate of change for this function f of x equals something at x equal 2 or something. There was always some value given, okay? And so we really ended up finding the derivative. This is the derivative. So the derivative of a function f of x is the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. And usually we write that shorthand instead of having to write out the derivative of f of x. We write it as an f, the function, the original function, and a little apostrophe right there after the function. And this apostrophe we read as prime. So I read this out loud, f prime of x, or the first derivative of x. Okay? Now, we know from everything that we've done before that this gives us two pieces of information about this function, right? That we can plug in a point. So I can plug in a point x is equal to a, and then this is the instantaneous rate of change of f at some point a. It's also the slope of the tangent line at a, right? So both of those interpretations are true when you plug in this point. Otherwise, this is a legitimate function all on its own. It tells us information about the entire function f, where it's defined, okay? So I want to go down and just make sure there are some different notations that we use sometimes for the derivative. So for the most part, I end up using this f prime notation. That's the one that I am comfortable with. Sometimes we also have an idea of y is equal to f of x, and in that case we can use y prime for notation. There's also kind of a very different notation than this prime notation, and that is that we use a letter d, df, the derivative of f with respect to x. Here, you also can see dy dx, and that's a dy and a divided by sign and dx in the denominator. It doesn't mean division, it's just the same derivative, means take the derivative with respect to x. And sometimes if we just want to talk in general, especially about notation, before we take a derivative, we do something like this. Take the derivative with respect to x of this thing f of x. And you'll see that in just a couple minutes when we do some of the rules. Okay? So for I just want to do one more example so that I'm sure that you guys are with me about using this definition. So and I assume that we're there because we've been practicing. So use the limit definition. Of the derivative to find f prime of x for f of x is equal to 3x squared plus 5. Now, when it says this verbiage, use the limit definition of the derivative. That means I have to go back to this limit, the definition that involves the limit. And this difference quotient. And I have to go back to that scratch. We're going to learn a whole bunch of shortcuts in the next few sections about how to calculate derivatives, just kind of like we did for limits. Remember near the end for polynomials, you can just plug in. That was kind of what I would call a shortcut. The same things occur for derivatives, and we'll find those some in this section and some in the coming sections. But this is the limit definition of the derivative. It means go back to the basics, okay? So I want to find f of x plus h. So I'll plug in x plus h here and find the difference quotient first, 3x squared plus 2xh. Plus h squared plus 5. And I get 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 5. Okay, so that's f of x plus h. And I'll plug this into the limit definition of the derivative. So find the difference quotient. So f of x plus h minus f of x over h, and I get 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 5 and minus the original function, which was 3x squared plus 5 and all divided by h. Okay? So I'm going to go ahead and simplify that. You'll see when I get rid of these brackets that a lot of this cancels. So I get the 3x squared to cancel and 5 to cancel, and I think I'm left with 6xh plus 3h squared over h. Okay, so I think we can go down and you can see if I factor out an h from this 6xh and from the 3h squared, the h's in my numerator and denominator will cancel and I'm left with 6x plus 3h. Now I haven't taken the limit yet, so I want to go ahead and do that. That's just the difference quotient. Now for the derivative, the limit as h goes to 0 of 6x. Plus 3h. When h gets really small, when it goes to 0, this piece here will go to 0. But it doesn't affect my 6x. Nothing's changing. So that's equal to 6x. And that is, ta-da, the derivative. F prime of x is equal to 6x. Okay? So that's using the limit definition of the derivative. Okay, in the next video, we'll start talking honestly about shortcuts for the derivative and then also interpretations of the derivative. But please let me know if you have questions.